What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, here for a continuation of the reading of the Bitcoin Dev mailing list. We've already done a couple videos here in the past about this, but I think we have currently a very important proposal that we need to discuss openly and in depth to what exactly is entailed here with everything that is included in the Taproot proposal, an email that was just recently published by Peter Woolley to the Bitcoin Dev mailing list. And we will just start out reading what he actually says here. Hello, everyone. Here are two BIP drafts that specify a proposal for a Taproot soft fork. A number of ideas are included. First, Taproot to make all outputs and cooperative spendings indistinguishable from each other. Merkle branches to hide the unexecuted branches in scripts. Schnorr signatures enable wallet software to use key aggregation and thresholds within one input. Improvements to the signature hashing algorithm, including signing all inputs and amounts. Replacing opcheck multisig and verify with opcheck sig add to support batch validation. Tagged hashing for domain separation to avoid issues like CVE 2012-2459 in Merkle trees. Extensibility through leaf versions, opsuccess opcodes, and upgradable pubkey types. There are three different BIPs that are included here. The BIP drafts can be found here. This one is for the BIP Taproot. This one specifies the transaction input spending rules. Then we have the BIP transcript, a Tapscript BIP, that specifies the change to script inside such spends. And we have the Schnorr BIP, is the Schnorr signature proposal that was discussed earlier on this mailing list. In initial reference implementation of the consensus change, plus preliminary construction and signing tests for the Python framework can be found on Peter Woolley's commits in about Taproot. Altogether, excluding the Schnorr signature module in libsecp256k1, the consensus changes are around 520 lines of code. While many others' ideas exist, not everything is incorporated. This includes several ideas that can be implemented separately without loss of effectiveness. One such idea is a way to integrate sighash no input, which we're working on as an independent proposal. The document explains basic wallet operations, such as constructing outputs and signing. However, a wide variety of more complex constructions exist. Standardizing these is useful, but out of the scope for now. It is likely we also desirable for define extensions to partially signed Bitcoin transactions, BIP 174, for interacting with Taproot. That too is not included here. Cheers, Peter Woolley. So this is the great email that he now here proposes with three links to three different BIPs. One for Schnorr signatures in general, one for transaction input sending rules of Taproot, and one for the changes in the scripts that we need for Taproot and Schnorr. So very interesting. And I thought, just for the shits and giggles and for why not, let's do a reading of all these BIPs, the Schnorr, the transcript, and the Tapscript and the Taproot BIP, because I think all of these are quite important here to talk about, all written by Peter Woolley. And there is one more contributor here, Mark Ludenberg, on the Schnorr BIP wiki here. So yes, this is it. They are not too technical. I think they can actually be understood if you have somewhat of a grasp and a willingness to accumulate this knowledge. So I think we can go through this and maybe skip some of the specifications here that might be too technical for a reading like this. But also what I want to show or talk to you about is to somewhat break it down more accessibly for you to understand what exactly these three BIPs contain and why they are so important, because they will be discussed about. It's important that if you are running a full node, you know exactly what you are signaling for or not, right? Because even abstaining vote of a soft fork, for example, and whatever software you run on your full node, for not running a Schnorr compatible full node is also missing out on many things. And we've seen especially how SegWit was implemented and that it currently is still not used by the vast majority of people. I mean, we're getting to back 32 percentages higher and higher, which is good. But of course, we still need to do much more onboarding. And this video this series is then part of the effort here of educating peers in advance to what this actually is, to help you make you a decent choice with which software you want to support on your own full node. And I think that the great benefits of Schnorr and Taproot are very powerful, and that this is very much worth getting educated about and trying to figure out what this is actually entails. So again, we will do a somewhat of a light reading and conversation about this, maybe get on again a couple times different peers who have contributed to this. Please also check out the YouTube video we have with Jonas Nick at the Understanding Bitcoin Conference, which explains a lot of the concepts in Schnorr. So this is definitely very, very needed. And we have also read the Taproot and Graftroot mailing list entry by Gregory Maxwell from a couple years back when this was first proposed. So peers, get educated about this. This is coming to your Bitcoin implementation. And if you would like to support this software, then you first need to make your own judgment about whether or not this is high quality or not. So again, do your own research, right? Accumulate this knowledge from a wide eclectic array of sources, which you are by reading the mailing list and the BIP. Right, but what I want to give you here is a accessible way to this knowledge, with me somewhat explaining to you as to the best of my abilities. And by the way, I will probably make a couple explains or mistakes in this explanation, and it will not be optimal. But nevertheless, let's try to understand this all. This is a rabbit hole that we go down as peers. So again. Do your own research, right? But I'm looking forward to this because I think this is a really, really, really important upgrade to Bitcoin with great promise and a lot of usability. Overall good improvement to Bitcoin. And I think it is worth to educate each other about this and to fight the good fight on getting this included into the Bitcoin consensus protocol with a soft fork in a non-contentious manner. So peers, this was it so far. Please support this channel if you like this. Get us some new microphones. Already are 34% for 17 donations, which is awesome. 3.4 million Satoshis already of the 10 million we need. So thank you very much to all the contributors to the World Crypto Network. And thank you, of course, to Peter Woolley and all the other contributors to getting this implementation for Schnorr and Taproot at least in a rough draft so that we can have a good conversation about it. Piers, thank you very much for joining me here today, and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.